Have you ever watched Benji Fishy and been in awe at how amazing of a WKeer he is? Seriously, man, Benji is nuts, but how does he do it? Like, what are his secrets? What's going on, guys? This is not your ordinary guy. No. This is your motivation guy. That's right. I'm here to motivate you to be great, not only in this game, but also in life. Keep going, my friends. This is your friend, the one and only Keith Allen, Bunch of Crunch Army. Man, let's change this world, man. I hope you guys are staying positive. Keep your head up because I believe in you. All right. So today I'm going to be showing you 9 tricks and techniques Benji Fishy uses to W key like a legend. These tricks will help you guys choose the right targets, finish your kills quicker, and most importantly, keep you from dying to cracked out 10-year-olds with too much time on their hands. And I love you guys too, whoever's 10, I love you. Keep in mind though, all right, Benji used most of these tips in low point hype night and cash cup games. Still, even if you don't play events, like, they work just as well against players in arena. Though, if you're struggling to climb an arena, there's a decent chance it has to do with your mentality, man. And that's why, yo, you gotta check out our free group classes over at ProGuys.com, where I myself, your friend, your guy, we have our new show, Your Motivation Show. We're gonna help you tackle problems like raging, anxiety, performance issues. Yo, check me out, man, every Wednesday and Friday, PST Standard Time, man. It is going down. All right, Bunch of Crunch Army, let's get this video started. Here we go. It's time to sit back, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. What is that, y'all? It's that Bunch of Crunch. And let's get this going. All right, guys, our first tip to W key like Benji is to rapidly cover as many parts of the map as possible, especially the major POIs. You know plenty of players drop. To do this, okay, you ideally need some mythics. So what Benji did in a recent 30 bomb game was land at the agency, eliminating everybody he saw. Once he got Jules Grappler, I mean, he didn't even spend his mid game mindlessly running around. He didn't do that. He just grappled all the way over to Lazy Lake, where usually you can find other players still fighting. Then he went over to Caddy Corner, where he found and just yoinked the Shockwave player's loot. And once Benji had the Caddy launcher, it was nonstop from there. I mean, tons of ramping up and diving into fights he spotted. Another item he used to scout for frags was launch pads, since he ended up getting so many. But unless you're dropping double digits, you probably don't have too many pads to toss around, right? I know this is more of a meta tip on how to find kills, but don't worry, my friends. These next ones, it's going to teach you guys how to secure kills quickly. And one of the best ways to secure kills is with the Caddy launcher. Anytime you get your opponent low and they box up, it's pretty easy to launch yourself directly into the box. All right, the problem is though, like, if you don't know what you're doing, you might end up launching yourself a bit too far. So the simplest way to set up a successful box dive is to place a wall about 3 floor pieces away from their box. Then position yourself about 2 floor pieces from their box. And once you're ready, like, shockwave around the center of your wall to go flying into your opponent's box. But you gotta be careful. Really skilled opponents will see it coming and might edit to shoot while you set it up. So make sure your opponent is low first and make sure you're quick at setting this up. All right, moving on, man. Another trick Benji uses a ton is the launch pad block. I know we've all been in this scenario. We spend forever fighting a player only for them to end up padding out. That happens, and more often than not, there's just not much you can really do about it. But if you're in range and quick enough, a simple cone can just block off the launch pad. And not just from above or where you can see it, but even from underneath too. I guess this is easier said than done. I get it. So my advice is to try to listen for the sound of the pad getting placed. Condition yourself to pull out your cone once you hear it, and with enough practice, you can start blocking more and more. And that alone can be the difference you need to rack up another kill. The next thing we noticed Benji doing a ton was targeting weak bases. By weak bases, we mostly mean bases built out of wood. I mean, they're just easy to break. And you can see what your opponent is doing inside. All around, fantastic for WKers. And tons of lower level players still camp in wooden bases, which, you know is a big no-no if you've ever watched our video. Still, it's not just wood though. Editing your walls of any material will considerably weaken their health for a few seconds. And Benji recognizes this. When he sees a metal box get edited, that becomes as good as wood to him, and he'll just pounce right at it. So be on the lookout, guys, for wood or recently edited bases, especially during mid or late game situations. Now, before the next insanely awesome trick, we gotta tell you this. Benji Fishy made his own master course, which we have on our website. You guys gotta check it out. All right, next up is the mind game technique that you can use to safely bait out shots. And it really works well with the charged shotgun that players really love to hold on you. All you need are some quick reflexes and control the wall your opponent is behind. And it's really, really easy, right? Like, all you gotta do is edit part of the wall so that you're exposed, but then reset it ASAP and just hold it. If you do it quickly enough, you're exposed for only a split second, which should be enough to bait your opponent's shot. And from here, and I mean like right here, you can follow up with another wall edit into piece control for the kill. Now, of course, Benji's on zero ping and it plays on keyboard and mouse, so he has a bit of an advantage over most of us. But even on controller, I mean, it's still doable, just as long as you practice your edits. And if edits are something you struggle with, our advanced warm-up course can definitely turn you into an editing monster, so check it out. But anyways, like, one thing Benji does a ton while WKing is replace structures with his assault rifle. He very rarely pulls out his pickaxe to try to take walls or other pieces. Why? Well, because with how reckless players can be, they might edit out and catch him with his pickaxe out. But another reason is that you can do it from further away, and lower level players just don't expect the wall replays when they hear shooting. And since you can do it from further away, you can stand back a whole tile, take a wall, follow up with a blueprint edit, which almost no one expects. Though if you're going to start following Benji's footsteps by replacing walls with ARs, all right, one thing that you need is excellent awareness of your ammo count. The last thing you want to do is pull out your AR for the kill only to find out that you forgot to reload. So keep a mental count of your ammo and remember to reload as often as possible. Now, have you ever been in a situation where you crack your opponent's shields, but then they crank up the hill? Yeah, it could be annoying, man, chasing them down. Wow. But this is the variation of the ramp phase we saw Benji do, which can help you secure those limbs much faster. So anytime your opponent is hailing one box above and you want to dive right in, to start by weakening their wall down to one shot health, then jump, attach a ramp, and just look down to place a floor. And finally, run up to the wall, then jump forward and shoot at the same time to phase right in, all right? Yes, I know, this is pretty much just a specific way to just set up the ramp phase technique, but since you pop up from below, no one really expects it, unlike, you know, if you just set up a traditional ramp phase. So knowing how to do this technique might just be what stops your opponent from healing and dragging on the fight. But when it comes to ending fights quickly, knowing and practicing, the cone floor double edit is a must. We all know that when you're pressuring someone in their box, a really common move is for them to edit out the side and just expand their base. So what Benji and a lot of pros do is quickly place a cone and a floor on the side they think their opponent is moving. They edit through, then follow up with some walls and a cone inside. And if done correctly, okay, the opponent ends up trapped with nowhere to go. This move has you place a lot of builds, but it's supposed to happen in one swift movement. So if you feel like you're slow at this, all right, just spend some time in creative, just getting the pattern down. You got it. With enough practice, I mean, you can get to the point where you're pretty much doing it automatically in build fights, and trust me, it can lead to so many more kills. Lastly, what puts Benji Fishy well above your average WK here is knowing when to stop. Even in games where Benji's pushing for a 30 bomb, he still won't mindlessly just WK every player he sees. Instead, when he's put in situations where he doesn't have the advantage, he takes a step back. If he gets tagged up in a fight, right, he uses whatever he can do to reposition, get some heals off, and reset the engagement. Or if there's a third party that joins the battle, he doesn't always commit to the kill that he's chasing unless he's already very close to finishing them off. Sometimes, he'll even disengage fully, leaving the player he was chasing entirely and switching focus to something else. Because really, knowing when to stop is a crucial aspect of WKing. So, you know, if you lack these things like the HP advantage or perhaps you're getting teamed up on, more often than not, guys, it's better to ignore the kill. Focus on disengaging so you can just reset and just play it from there. All right, guys, once again, this is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen, Bunch of Crunch Army. Man, keep going, man. Let's be leaders of our generation. Let's do it. Connect with me on my Insta at your motivation guy. I hope you guys enjoyed learning a bit about, you know, how Benji WKs. Benji's an absolute legend, and his late game guide on our site has plenty more of information on how to improve and really play just like him. So you guys got to check it out below, all right? Either way, let me know what tip you found most helpful. And if you want to see more videos like this, leave a like, you know, comment which pro that you want us to analyze, and just, you know, make sure that you're subbed with that noti bell so, you know, you don't miss out. Keep eating that bunch of crunch, and let's get this going. We'll be right back.